What is good, YouTube? It is Coach Ryan Rizuki, and today we are talking about pick and rolls, and I want to help you with the IQ and understand what to look for, where, when, and why. So let's take a look at it. Now, if I'm a quick athletic guard, I want to normally be coming off of flat drag screens. And so a drag screen is a screen that is set a lot further than that three-point line, closer to half court, maybe between those two lines. But that's what I want because this allows me to quickly choose a side. It does not matter which way. Come off the screen and go straight downhill as fast as I can. So for instance, if I have my defender here in front of me, I can quickly make a move, drive off that flat drag, and play downhill. Whether I get into my floater game, whether I get into my layups, or whether I get into a pull-up jump shot, it doesn't matter. But the beauty of this is that I can turn either direction, and that defender, right, is really high, so he doesn't have enough time for this guy to help, because I can go straight downhill at that big man or that weak defender, and it makes my job really easy to go downhill, make plays, to pass to my teammates, or hit my roller. Now, this is just one example of a screen, but we'll talk about a lot of the things that you want to look for, whether it be a flat drag, or whether it just be a flat middle pick and roll, or what you'll commonly see is just this angled pick and roll, forcing me more to a side than with his back to the basket. And I've broken down some of this terminology, and I will again in the future when I have more people with me, but I want to just quickly give you a look at some of the things that you need to look for when you come off these screens. Now, the first thing that you want to do before you come off any screen is to set your defender up. So make sure that you get them below the level of the screen and then come off the screen. Make sure you get your shoulder to your screener's hip and then attack downhill. Your first option is always to score. You want to look to attack, and being aggressive will allow everything else to open up. When your teammates start to get open, the defense is going to have to suck in more. And this is where you're going to get your little behind the back passes on a pop, your hook passes for the other man on the strong side that you originally came from, technically the weak side now, or you're going to find your rollers. But you want to be able to come off that screen attacking first, and then you're looking to make the passes out of it. You always want to look back at the side that you originally came from, because you can already see the side that you're going towards. But if you look back, you'll find your roller, and if the defense sucks in, you'll find the man on the weak side that you originally came from, and he'll be open, lifting up from that corner. So make sure that you come off these screens looking to attack first. Off the screen, you can also reject the screens like you'll see in these two examples here. You don't have to use them if the defense overplays, but here I'm showing you how you want to come off and look back at the side that you originally came from. This is something I'm working on with these two guards. As they come off these screens, they first attack, and then they're looking to make these passes for the pick and pop. They're looking to make these passes for the pick and rolls. They're looking to make these passes for different scenarios, but the most important thing, and I don't see a lot of guards do this, is when you come off the screen, first attack, and then always look back.